Hi, my name is Bill. I play music. My studio is located in West Oakland, California. It's the kind of place you don't want to meet somebody on the street. In fact, if you see somebody walking towards you, you should probably change direction quickly. The sidewalks are literally littered with discarded stolen radios, their wires all in a jumble. Massive exterior walls of the industrial facilities provide the perfect canvas for your local spray paint Picassos. Chemical waste trucks squeeze through small doorways. Broken glass shines like diamonds. My studio is right near the Bay Bridge entrance. The air here by the water hangs heavy and fragrant and breathes new life into your lungs. The morning sun bathes the skin and pressure washes your soul. Despite all the refuse, despite the ever-present danger of getting mugged or worse, this place feels magical and enriching, in the morning anyways. This area is neglected, but in actuality, this neglect is crucial to its magic. It hasn't yet been infected with artisanal frozen yogurt, Spanish tapa, yoga, dog wash, oxygen, vaping, capitalist vampires. There's garbage everywhere and toxic waste, and that's just the way we like it. I came here from Austin, Texas, but it all got too familiar, and familiarity is death. Once everything becomes familiar, you either have to change your perception or you have to move. So I moved to the Bay. It's really, really, really weird area. Blind white teeth bite permatan yoga pant delivery on demand. Sharing economy floods gutters, slow invisible drain. Feels like endgame. The beatniks and hippies and Jack London and the old bohemians from the days of 49 being snowed over in a blizzard of dollars from digital clouds held humming in Mountain View, Palo Alto, and the hills above. I know there's survivors strewn amongst the herd. There are some really great people I've met out here. In my building, there's a company that disposes of chemical waste. They have those green hoses and everything. On the other side of me, they lacquer furniture, also providing a unique odor. The scale of the place is beyond anything I've ever experienced. It feels like it was designed for airplanes being flown by giant ogres. Inside my studio, I'm finally in my place in the world, where you leave everything plugged in so you can chase down an idea. Even though I'm a vegetarian, I imagine that the creative process is like hunting a deer with a slingshot. Sometimes you get lucky right away, but it probably takes hours and hours of seemingly wasted effort before you get something that sticks. I'm really interested in drone music. A lot of my songs originate from drones, open tunings too. Lately I've been favoring the open C tuning I learned about from Nick Drake. I was also really inspired by Lamont Young, who apparently has been holding down the same note for 30 years or something. Sometimes I feel like I've devoted my whole life to an art form the world has declared dead. The album, the recording process. Oh well. I recently bought an Edison wax cylinder. It was shaped just like a Coke can, and I thought to myself, this whole art form, making records, it's very much a temporary thing. I'm sure whoever made that wax cylinder thought this was the end-all be-all of post-industrial artistry. But the truth is, when the music feels right and it's flowing through you, technology doesn't matter. It's a tool to help you get there, but once you're there, nothing matters except you and the music and the moment you're inhabiting. I get inspiration everywhere, but coffee really helps. I drink a lot of coffee, like an insane amount of coffee. You just get habituated and then you have to up the dose. You know that whole drill. There's a notion on the West Coast of the musician, the writer, the composer, as instrument builder. Engaging directly with the process, you create your own tools. It's all about creating something new. I like this idea, but I also still like playing a C chord in first position on the guitar. Sometimes innovation for innovation's sake feels pointless, a distraction. Should always be in service to the music that you want to make. My studio tables are littered with the detritus of a life lived creatively. Soldering iron, ancient video mixers, old cathode ray tube televisions, reel-to-reels coming out my ears, screen printing materials, guitars and lights and cables and stuff that I don't even know how it got here. I draw inspiration from many places. I think in the old music industry, you had a very strict division of labor. But now that the industry has pretty much been decimated, artists have to fend for themselves. You have to write the songs yourself, record them yourself, shoot your own videos, design your own artwork, screen print the merch, and lastly, figure out how to divide the $20 you made at the door amongst five people. I personally use a calculator. John Cage has been a big inspiration. Nick Drake, who I mentioned. John Prine's Turns of Phrase, Delia Derbyshire, Todd Rundgren's early pop records. Terry Riley's A Rainbow in Curved Air, No Pussy Footing by Frippinino, Old Folk Recordings, Daniel Johnston, Robert Johnson, Townes Van Zandt's Strings of Images, especially on his first few records. The first album by Lower Dens, the mid-90s work of Stereolab, the writings of Ian Savonius, Harry Nilsson's Eighth Note Right Piano Hand, Polyrhythmic Tape Echo, the sound and visuals from these Atari video games people keep giving me. I think the world is kind of fucked up, but you can't give up on the world. The world needs you, needs your mind, needs your creativity. Creativity, openness, and empathy are the only ways forward. My name is Bill, and I play music.